Sega Drunk.
Two of the best cheap cartridges you can get for the Super Nintendo have long been the Tiny Toons games made by Konami, Buster Busts Loose, and the four-player compatible Wacky Sports Challenge. The Sega Genesis has two Tiny Toons games of its own, also made by Konami, Buster's Hidden Treasure and Acme All-Stars. Starting with Buster's Hidden Treasure, this game is your traditional hop-and-bop Mario-style platformer, complete with a world map, 24 different levels, and all the generic platforming settings like the ice stage, the fire stage, the forest stage, you get the idea. It's a little different from its SNES Tiny Toons counterparts, however, since the dash mechanic is done away with, more or less, in this game you just begin to run the longer you hold down left or right, and you press the B button to slide into enemies, which is pretty fun. You also hold down and a horizontal direction to crawl, which helps you slow down. One fun aspect of the SNES game was being able to climb walls, and you can still do that in this game too, just by doing a good old-fashioned wall jump. There are special items you can find that enable help from your friends. Press the C button, and Little Beeper, Concord Connor, or Sneezer will clear the screen of enemies. Speaking of those characters, this game does a great job representing the Tiny Toons franchise. You see almost everyone from the show in this game, all their likenesses are recreated perfectly. It helps that the story is geared in a way that you get to see a ton of characters, since Montana Max enlisted Elmira to kidnap and hypnotize Babs, Plucky, Fifi, Hampton, among others, to help Max look for treasure. So yeah, if you liked the show, you'll really like this game. Like I said, there's 24 levels, and every few, you have to fight a boss fight where you have to take out this scientist that has your Toon friends hooked up to these hypnosis helmets, and it's your job to bust them loose. This game isn't very long, but there is a password system here if you need it. But yeah, Buster's Hidden Treasure is a really well-made game. Sure, it's all the usual settings, but at least they all look great, and the music is pretty good too. Plus, this is the kind of platformer you can approach in a couple different ways. You can collect everything and go for 100%, or you can speedrun and finish the game as quickly as possible. The boss fights are also really well done, but I gotta say, this game is pretty dang easy, as you might expect. If you want a challenge, you'd be better off looking elsewhere, but either way, Buster's Hidden Treasure is yet another great Tiny Toons game. It seems this franchise can't go wrong when it comes to video games. And that brings me to Tiny Toon Adventures Acme All-Stars. Again, this is the Genesis answer to the Super Nintendo's Wacky Sports Challenge. This is a series of five arcade-style games featuring basketball, soccer, and bowling, in addition to an obstacle course race and whack-a-mole, where you beat the crap out of Montana, which is pretty funny. Again, this is a great representation of the show, nailing the color palette and the art style perfectly, and there's 12 playable characters here, some even with unique moves. That's pretty cool. Okay, they're not really all that unique from each other, but it's still a nice touch. The basketball and soccer stand out here in particular as fun. They're both 3-on-3, and both have the same kind of vibe that the Super Nintendo's Looney Tunes B-Ball has, just a crazy, fast-paced, no-holds-barred style that's really fun, especially with a second player. There's no fouls or offsides or anything, so you can just go nuts. Those two are definitely the highlight here. The other three games really feel like mini-games without much to them. Bowling is just, you know, bowling. Whack-a-mole is kind of fun for a minute or two, and the obstacle course is over before you know it. One interesting feature here is the story mode. Unlike Wacky Sports Challenge, you can actually quote-unquote finish this game. You have to complete all the events in order, some more than once, and there's even a password system to save your progress. I'm not sure if that sort of thing is going to be much of a selling point for anyone, but I thought it was interesting enough to point out. So yeah, I don't know what it is about the combination of Konami and Tiny Toons, but they can't seem to miss. Even when the game is just okay-ish like Acme All-Stars, it's still got some great qualities, and Buster's Hidden Treasure in particular is one worth seeking out even if you don't care for Tiny Toons. It's just a well-made platformer. The bottom line is, if it says Tiny Toons and Konami on the label, you can't go wrong.